The New Mexico Outdoor to Antonito and back, Antonito, Colorado, is as beautiful as the Durango to Silverton world famous drive. But yet, I guess we're fortunate to be right on this route. We just passed Red Mountain in Abiquiu. It overlooks Abiquiu. And then, of course, Abiquiu Lake. Just after Abiquiu Lake, there's Gabriella, but in the background is the Continental Divide Trail as it empties into the Rio Chama Canyon. And you can see Ghost Ranch off in the distance amongst all the red rock and the Kitchen Mesa at Ghost Ranch.
Well, from where that osprey sits up there on its eggs slash babies, it can see Rio de los Bravos and can see Heron Lake and Elvado Lake. So it goes fishing over there, and it also joins the Osprey Fest in fall. So we're up here. We're between Tierra Amarilla and Chama, and there's one of the participants in the Osprey Fest. So you got to come here and see these guys. It's amazing because we're Easterners, saltwaterers, and also Floridians. And yeah, osprey, absolutely. But right here in north central New Mexico, a population of osprey? You betcha. See that one staring you right in the face, going, "What the hell are you shooting?"
The Tierra Amarilla incident. On June 5th, 1967, in Tierra Amarilla, a small band of Chicanos affiliated with the Federal Land Grant Alliance attempted to arrest the county's district attorney and put him on trial. There were shots fired and two men were wounded. The invaders held the courthouse for 2 hours, ransacking it, but the district attorney was not in town. The National Guard, equipped with tanks, was called in by then Governor of New Mexico, David Cargo. While the gunmen were in hiding, the National Guard held many of their family members captive. This incident received national publicity and brought the alliance's cause to public attention. Herein is the tribute to this revolution in Land or Death, with the picture of the leader, Reyes Tejerina. And that still stands today, obviously. We really like the Elkhorn Lodge in Chama, and in fact, if you're headed north into Chama, it's only about a mile outside the village proper, and it's right on the Rio Chama. They have like a dozen cabins and maybe 30 or 40 rooms and a nice restaurant. It's really fun.
This is the Rio Chama as it flows south out of the Colorado Rockies, where we're headed right now. And it's passing the Elkhorn Lodge. And the Elkhorn Lodge is a great place in Chama for you to stay. We've been here on the Saturday night shows that they have, and they have bonfires. And I'll tell you, it's just an enchanting place. And this Rio Chama up here in the summer, you can see fly fishermen, or what do they call that up in Alaska? It's combat fishing. Combat fishing. Well, we just left the Elkhorn Lodge, where we had a great breakfast at the Elkhorn Lodge restaurant, and we're headed towards downtown Chama, New Mexico. And see those mountains out there? That's Colorado, just a few miles in front of us, and that's where we're headed, into those mountains and up to, let's let this light adjust here. Yeah, there it is. And then up to the Cumbres Pass, and then out to Wolf Creek Pass, and we're wondering if that Wolf Creek Pass is like Wolf Creek Ski Area, which receives more snow every year than any other place in Colorado, believe it or not.
Now a few shots of Chama. Chama, like a lot of New Mexico, little known fact, is 8,000 feet in elevation and is really ponderosa pine, high pine landscape, looking a lot like what people picture Colorado. And indeed, it's very close to the Colorado line.
We're at Chama, and this is the Cumbres-Toltec Railroad, which is a historic steam engine, and be sure to visit that page because we were able to ride that thing, and I'll tell you what, it was fun. For an hour, I go to sleep about that stuff, but Gabriella just loved it. Didn't you love that thing?
I loved it.
Luna wasn't yet born. We're on 17 Scenic Drive from Chama to Antonito, Colorado. And this is the route of the Cumbres-Toltec Scenic Railway. It's a historic railway. And the smokestack actually blows out what are called cinders. And in a dry season, they are concerned that these cinders are going to cause a fire. This fire vehicle actually follows the road to the train, which is, by the way, right up here. We'll be able to see it better in a minute. That vehicle makes sure that forest fires are reported, put out, or and contained. There it is, Cumbres Pass, right there. And there's the train at Cumbres Pass. This is the Cumbres-Toltec Scenic Railway, and that steam engine right there burned thousands of gallons of water to make steam, and is reloading water right here at Cumbres Pass. This pass is, 9,000 feet and change, or maybe even 10,000 feet. And it's going to continue on to its halfway point, which is called... Yeah, well, they're going to have some lunch, and a nice lunch. Look at them. That thing is being cooled down. That engine must be pretty darn hot because it's being cooled down. Well, we took the scenic railway 2 years ago at about right now, and there was snow up here. We're going to see if there's snow up here, and we'll be back at you for sure. What an exciting moment to catch this thing right at Cumbres Pass, seeing it cooled down. We didn't know that it had to be cooled down. Isn't that cool?
Oh, it's great. I love it.
Cumbres Pass, at about 10,022 feet elevation, is infamous, really, for a major encounter between the U.S. Army and a large group of Utes and Jicarilla Apaches occurring sometime about July 1848. Old Bill Williams, the famous scout and guide, was badly wounded while fighting the Utes, who had actually once adopted him as a tribesman. Cumbres Pass is now a watering spot for the Cumbres-Toltec Railway. The steam engine uses thousands and thousands of gallons of water to produce steam while headed up the mountain to Cumbres Pass.
Lots of updraft here for sure, coming out of the desert into 10,000 feet. That's the Cumbres-Toltec Railway, Scenic Railway, and we rode that a couple years ago. Be sure to visit that page. You see Gabriella and Luna down there to meet the railroad.
Conejos Canyon, pronounced Conejos, stretches out for miles and miles and miles and remains one of the wildest areas in Colorado. The Conejos River begins many miles upstream in the rugged San Juan Mountains, where the last known grizzly bear in Colorado was found. From its headwaters, the Conejos River runs 90 miles down the canyon to join the Rio Grande in the San Luis Valley.
This is the Conejos River, and it runs through the Conejos Valley, and boy, is it beautiful down in here. And moreover, it's a mecca for Rio Grande cutthroat trout fishermen, huntermen, bears. I'll tell you, this place is full of mountain lion, and more on that later. But right now, just this Conejos Valley on the other side of the mountains. Hey, there goes a chipmunk beast right there, gone. So here we are. You know, this is paradise to me, I'll tell you that. Well, we're now in the Rio Grande National Forest, out of the San Juan National Forest. In the San Juan Mountains, the Conejos Valley, which means wabbit, in the Colorado Rockies. And, you know, we're right along the, this is not the Rio Grande, this is the Rio Conejos. We want to keep saying something else. So here we are, and we're going to see if she's going to go hand fishing trout. There are Rio Grande cutthroat trout in this Rio, and it's a beautiful Rio, I'll tell you that. It looks very clean. And is it cold? It's a mountain stream. And then Luna found herself a Rio Grande cutthroat trout right there for lunch. She's a very self-sufficient dog. Her nose can sniff out dead stuff. Yeah. It's a beautiful Colorado mountain river, the Rio Cajones. Is that right, Rio Cajones?
No, Conejos!
Conejos is correct! See.
This haunting church, even under a clear blue sky in Mogote village in Colorado near Antonito, it's a it's a shell of a church, and but active cemetery it looks like, and it's very near Antonito, which is the northern terminus of the Cumbres-Toltec Scenic Railway. And as we head south out of Antonito, we see San Antonio Mountain, which is in New Mexico. And not long after that, headed south, and let me let you know, by that mountain, there's a herd of just tons and tons of pronghorn antelope. But we can see Cerro Pedernal off in the distance. And once we get all the way back down to 84 off of 285, there's Red Mountain in the village of Rio Chama, which crowns our lower Rio Chama Valley.